Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, amma ba'd. This evening we look at the Al Yasir family. Many, many years before the advent of Islam, in Yemen, there were four brothers. One was Yasir, one was Harith, and one was Malik. And their fourth brother went somewhere to the north and wandered off. And he had lost his way. So the three brothers, Yasir, Malik, and Harith, set out to look for their brother. And while searching for their brother, they split up. And Malik and Harith returned to Yemen. And Yasir then began to live in Makkatul Mukarramah. He was drawn by the Baytullah. The only challenge for him was that he had no family in Makkatul Mukarramah. So he entered into a friendship with the Banu Makhzum tribe. And they gave him security and protection, because that is how things worked in that day. That you needed to know people, and only if you had a friendship or your family, then they would protect you. Otherwise, you were at the mercy of anyone and everyone. So Yasir began to live in Makkatul Mukarramah. And he had that friendship with the Banu Makhzum tribe. From the Banu Makhzum tribe, there was Abu Huzaifa bin Mughira al-Makhzumi. And he had a slave girl by the name of Sumayya. Yasir married Sumayya. And from that union, there was a boy that was born, and his name was Ammar. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi announced the message of Islam, then Ammar immediately accepted the deen of Islam. And he came to Darul Arqam and he proclaimed Islam. Then he went back to his home and he announced his deen to his father Yasir and his mother Sumayya. And all three now became Muslim. And this was one of those families where everyone had accepted Islam in the family. But because they did not have any support, the Quraysh and all the people of Makkah really would torture them, chastise them, torment them. And there was no one to protect them. It is said on one day that someone even tried to burn Ammar. And while they were burning him, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came by and he said these words, "Kuni barda wa salaman ala Ammar, kama kunti bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim." Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam addressed the fire and he said, "Be a peace and coolness for Ammar, like how you were a peace and coolness for Sayyidina Ibrahim." Sayyidina Uthman says, "One day I was walking with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on the outskirts of Makkah. And when we came there, we noticed that the whole family, Yasir and Sumayya, as well as Ammar, were being tortured by the leaders of the Kuffar. And at that time, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to them, sabran, sabran, that patience, perseverance, inna maw'idakum al-jannah, your promised abode is Jannah." Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave them that glad tidings. And then on individual occasions, they were all being persecuted. And that is what eventually led to the end of Hazrat Sumayya, that she was being tormented by Abu Jahl. He was saying all sorts of things to her, and she just didn't pay any attention to him. And he continued to hurl abuse at her, and she didn't pay attention. And he got so aggravated that he took a spear and he stabbed her in the front, and it came out of her back. And like that, she was martyred. She was the first person to give her life for the deen of Islam. It wasn't long after that the husband Yasir was also then tortured to the point where he lost his life. So Ammar's mother and father both passed on, yet the Kuffar continued to torture him and persecute him. Till one day he came to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and he said, "Oh Nabi Allah, I'm in a very bad condition." So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked, what has happened? What is the matter? So he says, "No, I cannot even say it." So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked him to explain. He says, "The Kuffar were torturing me to such an extent that they made me say certain things against you and against Allah, and they made me acknowledge their idols." And at that, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "But how do you find your heart?" So he said, "Mutma'innum bil iman." Then at that point, verses were revealed,
من كفر بالله من بعد إيمانه إلا من أكره وقلبه مطمئن بالإيمان.
That if a person is forced to utter words of kufr, yet he doesn't say it believing in it, he says it merely to save himself, then that person remains a mu'min. And that is why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that Ammar is an embodiment of Iman. From head till toe, he is an embodiment of Iman. Then came the time when there was the Hijrah, and Sayyidina Ammar was amongst the first to make Hijrah. And when he reached the outskirts of Medina, at a place called Quba, he was the one who had assisted in building this masjid. And it is for that reason that we say that he was the first to build a masjid in the deen of Islam. He remained loyal to Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, sacrificing all that he had. And it is said that at the time of the Battle of Yamama, which was after the demise of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that was when some of the believers were running helter-skelter. And the enemy were quite formidable. They were those who had turned renegade. At that moment, Sayyidina Ammar stood up on a high place and he said, Ya ma'ashar al-Muslimin, O Muslimin, Ana Ammar, I am Ammar, Ta'al ilayya, come to me. And he said, when he was standing there and calling the people back, he was already injured to such an extent that his ear was cut off and it was dangling on the side. Yet he was the one who brought stability to the Muslim forces, and he called everyone together, and eventually the Muslims were able to defeat those who had turned kafir, who had turned renegade. It was in the Battle of Siffin that he lost his life. He was more or less the same age like Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and that is why at the time of his death, he was participating in the battle, yet he was almost 80 or coming on close to 90. This was in the 30th year after Hijrah, or around that time. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, there are three people for whom Jannah is desirous and waiting to have these people in it. The three is Sayyidina Ali, Sayyidina Salman, and Sayyidina Ammar. May Allah be pleased with all of them. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلق محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.